first question is, who has got the best jacket on this stage?
The flashiest
jacket. Well, yes, I'm trying to make up for a lack of talent by my jacket. Well, my dears, it's a joy to have you all on here and to be interviewing you this morning. Now, tell me, you just told me backstage that you were recently in L.A., so Los
Woo!
Angeles.
Woo! LA.
What are you doing in lovely L of the A, my dears?
Well, we can't tell you too much. As you know, we've signed a new record deal with BMG. We've got a new album out in November, and we were over in LA just discussing a worldwide release. So, watch this space.
Yes, well done, my dears. A worldwide release. Well, you see, I always think we've had one album called Act Two, haven't we? So I can't wait for Act, what are we on, Five now, is it right? Must be Act Five. So I think when we're here this time next year, or the year after, we'll be on Act 10, perhaps. All right, yes. So tell me, I always find it interesting, and I'm sure your collaborators know all about you, but tell me, for those people that are coming in here today who don't know you, of course most will, how did you form to begin with?
Well, basically, Matt and I were working on a contract in different countries for the same company performing in hotels. And we were talking about how difficult it is to get into the West End. And we'd been trying for a few years and nothing had really come of it. And we decided to make our own thing, make our own work. And so that we put something out on social media about how I wanted to form a musical theatre group, boy band, vocal crew. And basically, we found Tom and Michael in auditions, and they walked in the room, and we knew that we wanted them straight away. And
physically.
Don't flatter yourself.
It's how the industry works, my dear.
And that's it, really. It was great. And then we put it together for corporates and entertainment and stuff like that. And then actually, when we sang, we realised that something sort of quite special was happening, and we decided to go on Britain's Got Talent. And then won.
And then won. Yes, they won. Give us a yes. Thank you. Tell me, when you first got to go then, I found it fascinating because your harmonies are wonderful, they're so close. Did you work on it all together, or did you have somebody helping you with all the harmony work?
At the very start, we had a guy that was doing our vocal arranging, and a fun fact actually, obviously we sang Stars for the first audition of Britain's Got Talent, but the first song we ever sang together was Bring Him Home, and we rehearsed for a week before Britain's Got Talent, and then 3 days before we went on the show, we changed the song.
Oh God.
So there was no pressure at all.
Yeah.
But yeah, we had a guy working for us that did all the harmonies.
Do you know what the other fun fact is as well? Is
what?
That we had two songs prepared on the day, and we sang both of them through in the rehearsal. One of them was Stars, and the other one was
The Prayer.
The Prayer. And then we didn't sing that again until the second tour, did we?
No.
Oh, really? Fascinating, my dear. So tell me, something we're all very keen to know is, what do we all think of Simon Cowell's new face?
As the most diplomatic member.
He was about to answer and I was like, no.
I say nothing.
I think there's nothing wrong. He looks beautiful, right? Nothing wrong with him.
Yes.
Right?
Yes, of course. Yes, it's amazing what millions pays for in plastic. Look at me, my dear. You know? Got you all for it, isn't it? Now, something I've always wondered about with different groups and talent like yourselves, how you come up with your name? Did you kind of put lots of different names in a hat, or did you kind of, where did you find the inspiration for Collabro? What was that about?
Yeah, we're not sure.
Yeah.
I mean, there was a lot of different names flying around, wasn't there?
Yeah, and
but what are the other ones?
One of them was like the Green Room or something like that.
Was we heard that and we were like, no,
never.
Absolutely not.
Was
Encore,
the Pipes,
Spotlights,
the Pipes,
the Pipes,
Oh Danny Boy.
I don't remember it being called the Pipes.
No. It came from somewhere, but we're not quite sure.
I think you've made that up in your head.
Yeah.
the pipes. They guessed it, they never said it.
So it works.
We were almost called the pipes, you guys.
I think I got this reaction when I suggested it.
Well, that would make you all the pipers, wouldn't it? If they were the pipes, thank God that you didn't call yourselves the pipes, my dears, honestly. Now, another fun fact for you. You were voted UK's favourite Britain's Got Talent winners in a national poll, weren't they? Yeah! Oh, God, you're going to say something, Jamie. Go ahead.
That was until Britain's Got Talent, the champions.
Tell me what happened on the... Who won that? I didn't see any of that. Who won that?
Well, not us. Twist and Pulse?
Yeah, it was a very strange... It was a strange voting system because basically they had like... I think it was like 200 fans, super fans, who... And actually, our fans are great because they did get in there on our night, but we... that they just had these people in the sort of front. Was anyone there?
Yeah.
Yes.
Oh,
yeah. And they had people in the front who would vote. But we... Also, it's a bit strange because when... Oh, can't talk about that. No. In the episode, we actually closed the whole show.
Right.
They did that.
I'll leave that there. But it was strange because in the episode, they made it look like it was like a huge shock that we didn't get through.
Right.
And the audience reaction was really good and the judges' comments were really good. So it was a bit sad, really, but none of the previous winners got through.
Right.
There were seven, I think, and none of them went through to the final.
Basically, it wasn't a vote where people could ring up from home. It was a live audience vote.
Right.
So you had to impress the people that were there in front of you on the night, which didn't reflect, because it was a different audience every night, it didn't really reflect.
It's a bit random and new, isn't it?
Yeah, and also I think in an arena situation in Wembley, the dance acts and the danger acts tended to do really well and go through because it was that kind of thing that just in an arena space with the massive screens, in our night there was a guy called Alex, was it Magira? Magala. And he's he eats swords or something. Anyway, he did that thing where he slid down. Oh, it was terrible. Anyway, it was brilliant, but it was terrifying. And that worked really well.
Well, may I make a suggestion then? Just a tiny artistic suggestion for your... next time you go on that bloody show, or one similar to it, while singing, can you please put big bits of metal or other things in your mouth, or juggle fire, or go on big hooplas? Make it bloody dangerous, my dears.
Well,
Collabro the danger years.
Well, if you come and see us on Thursday...
Yes? Oh.
Oh.
My dears. Listen at that. Sword fighting at all with Collabro. We into that, my dears? Yes, we are. Right, now, one thing I must ask you. Now, who on... Well, no, we've done Britain's Got Talent. Now, let me ask you. If you weren't doing this today, what would you all be doing?
Still working in the restaurant? I think we'd all still be trying to perform in some way. We all grew up loving to sing and perform. The reason these guys came up with the idea of Collabro was because they wanted to find another way into performing. So I think we'd all still be trying. Maybe we'd be on the West End, I don't know. But
right.
Maybe
thankfully,
performing.
We don't have to think about that.
Oh yeah, all of our passions are singing. So if we weren't doing this, we'd still be pushing for a career in the West End.
Right, good. And of course, so Jamie and Michael, it was you that started with the idea of it. So do you get a higher percentage of the takings?
No. I think we get less.
We'll leave that one there. Let's go back to Simon Cowell's face, shall we? No. Let's have a look. So, yes, tell me, so you've got another album coming out soon, is this right?
We have indeed. It's a love album.
Oh. So what is your favourite love song from this album?
We've each got a difference. This is my bit. What do you mean love? We've each got
a difference. Are you alright, mate? Is there a medic in the house? Somebody needs to look down Jamie's throat, please.
Are you actually a medic, madam? This happened on BGT.
She's medically committed, my dear. God bless her. No, I'm only joking. Look at you. You're wonderful. Sorry, Jamie. Go on, my dear.
We've each got a different favourite song, but I think it probably changes because we've released two of them now. We've released Fix You, which is Coldplay, and Shallow from A Star Is Born, which we only released 2 days ago. And the rest of them we can listen to because we've because it's our
album. Album.
But I think my favourite at the minute is probably Somewhere Only We Know by Keane.
By Keane? Well, just, it's about time somebody made that song good, isn't it?
I think my favourite is My Heart Will Go On. Oh. We've done something different with it and we think it sounds beautiful, so hope you guys enjoy it.
Great.
I think my favourite is A Million Dreams. Yeah. I love the way that although we're doing a love album with pop music, we're still staying true to a bit of musical theatre as well.
My favourite is Can't Help Falling In Love With You, because you know, it's an absolute classic and it's nice to have that stripped back song on the album, because we do a lot of like big, brash numbers and then it's lovely to have this soulful melody in the middle.
Yes, well, we all look forward to listening to those, don't we, my dears? 1 a.m. in the morning, on my own, crying, listening to these words.
Sounds like Jamie's Friday nights.
It's my every night, my dear. So, listen, of course, you are so wonderful in musicals and everything, and I'm sure you are asked this all the time, but what musical would you all like to be in, most out of them all? What would be your favourite one? And if any of you say Shrek, I'll bloody kill you.
I can't dance and I can't really act, so I'd probably do Javert.
Yes, and maybe not.
As we know from the movie, you don't even have to be able to sing.
I was really hoping someone was going to say that.
Very true. I always say Russell Crowe, Russell No. Good God, what was he thinking? I mean, you know. Yes, good one, my dear. Javert, excellent.
Mine always changes, but I think at the minute, I think I would like to play Seymour in Little Shop of Horrors.
Oh, yes, wonderful. Wonderful.
That's changed. I've always said Link in Hairspray for this, but I actually got told recently I'm too old.
No. Really?
Yeah.
So. How old are you, dear?
29. I think it's more how I look. Do I look too old?
No.
You are just about to go over that hill, aren't you?
Oh. I'll join you in a minute then.
You know what you can do? You can speak to Simon Cowell's facelift man. Then you'll be fine for Link, won't you?
He'll come out looking worse.
All right, Thomas, yes.
Can I have two?
Yes, you may.
I would love to play Jack in Into the Woods.
Oh, yes.
And I would also love to play...
It's a
kid or an adult.
Or an adult.
It's normally done with an adult, but then the movie did it with a kid.
Well, you can do it on your knees, my dear.
Exactly. I would love
to play Oliver.
That's theatre.
The other one is Fabrizio in Light on the Piazza.
Did you recently see that?
Yeah, it was amazing.
Yes.
With Dove Cameron.
That's right. Yes, it was great. Insane. Now, boys, how do you warm up? What is your favourite warm-up technique? Come on, what's your favourite?
Lunges.
Jumping jacks.
Yeah. Jumping jacks. Well, right. So I've got a warm-up. We're all going to do it. Are you ready, my dears? We're all going to say, we're going to go Michael John Bannerman Balls, right? And then John Michael Ball Bannerman, okay? So it's Michael John Bannerman Balls. Ball. No. Michael John Bannerman Balls. I've had too many gin and tonics, my dears. So we're going to go, bloody hell, let's have a think about this. What is, bloody hell, fucking hell did I do this? Oh, excuse me. Oh. Sorry, my dears, is it too early for that? Right, okay. So it's John Michael, no, fucking hell. Michael John Barrowman Balls, John Michael Ball Barrowman. Barrowman. Have you got it, Thomas? So John Michael Ball Barrowman, John Michael Ball Barrowman, Michael John Barrowman Balls. That's it. That's it. That's it. So we're going to do it. So we're all going to go. We're starting to do it. Michael John Barrowman Balls,
John Michael Balls Barrowman Balls.
Tell you what, why don't we all just go balls, 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 balls. Everyone, 1, 2, 3, 4.
Balls, 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 balls.
And now a long note. This is the collaborators with the collaboros. And together we are going to go balls on a really long note. Yes. Yes. 3, 2, 1.
Balls.
Balls.
Well done. Give yourselves a round of applause. Yes, nothing like high culture and art on this ship, is there, my dears? Change the last letter, you've got something else. Right, okay, so tell me what's your most embarrassing gig that you've done, my dears? The most embarrassing incident?
Oh.
can I do my Liverpool one? So we were in Liverpool once, and we were doing our Jersey Boys medley, and it was a BGT celebration show, and we were dancing, and I was a little bit clumsy, and I knocked the mic stand, and the mic stand hit the floor, and then the mic flew out of the mic stand, rolled across the stage, gone. And I was left a bit embarrassed.
You did style it out quite well, though, to be fair. And it was for charity.
So. Oh, yeah.
Jamie, tell them about your ring.
Oh no. Most of you already know this story. I had another story, but I will do this one.
Yes.
Oh, yeah. So we were in Canada for the first time, and only time ever. And it was great, we loved it. We were doing a tour of Ontario, and we were in a concert one night, and I had a ring on. And we were singing That's Life, Frank Sinatra. And there's a video of this on YouTube. I spin around, and da-da-da-da-da, spin, da, da. And my ring flew off and hit a lady in the face. Who is actually here, and she's come to about 60 concerts since.
So basically now they're engaged.
Did you let her keep the ring?
No, she gave it back. She actually went, got hit in the face by the ring, then searched the aisle for it to then bring it back to the stage.
Oh, I'm sorry. Divorced. I've got one from Michael. We were doing, Soccer Six? Michael kicked the ball into the audience, right into a girl's face.
Oh dear.
And he went over going, oh my God, are you okay? Are you okay? And she went, this is the best day of my life.
And
she hasn't washed her face since, my dear. She really hasn't.
Neither has he. So, Toms, I'll let you take over, but can you please tell the story of when you spoke the wrong language in a country that hasn't...
So we were doing a tour of... where was it? It was the Philippines and Taiwan. And I went to Taiwan, and we'd been flying over like one day here, one day there. I said, we know how to say good morning in Taiwan, don't we? And all the boys went, no. I went, Magandang Umaga! And everyone went, no, that's not right. I went, what country are we in? It was mortifying. Awful.
So, what language did you say?
That was in Filipino. That was in Tagalog.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
Great. Wrong.
And I literally went to the audience, is that right? And they went,
and the response was this.
Yes.
No. Oh, any more? We love these embarrassments.
The only other one I was thinking, do you remember on the second tour, we had a lift that brought us up to the stage? Yeah. And one time, the lift brought us up to the stage, and Jamie realised he didn't have his microphone. So then this little hand popped this microphone up through the floor.
It was the encore, it was Stars at the Royal Albert Hall. And I was like, guys, I haven't got a microphone. Oh, yeah.
I love it, my dear. Now, how long have we got left? Are we still all right?
Ages.
Well, ages, good, because we are going to do a Q&A, but I want to ask you a couple more things, right? So, I always find it good, lads like yourselves, that you worked hard, you've got where you've got, you really worked for it, and you just come from good, wholesome, normal homes and families, etc. How has fame changed you and affected you? Has it all been good? What are the ups? What are the downs? And what have you found significantly has changed in your lifestyle, apart from the clothes that you wear, of course?
I think one of the main things is we've all tried to be in the industry for years before we joined the group, and obviously we've had this success, and now we're just four best friends that get to do the job that we love. So it's I think that's a massive change, is we get to do it every day.
That's a beautiful thing. I'm crying internally. Yes, no, that's good. That's lovely, my dear.
We're quite lucky because unlike in being in a show, with what we do a lot of touring. We do a lot of our stuff is hotels and traveling, and we're quite lucky because what people don't realise is that the being on stage and this part is probably 5% of what goes into it, and it's quite a lonely industry in many ways because of the travelling. And if we weren't a group, it would be probably quite a tough life, but we're quite lucky to have each other because we do all the traveling together and we stay in all the hotels together, not in the same rooms, but you know, we're around. And whenever you need to be around somebody, someone is always there. So that's quite a lucky thing because that's probably the hardest part about the change from being in sort of a great regular job to suddenly doing what we do now is quite lonely. So being the four of us, we're quite lucky.
Yes, that's
I think it's really great that obviously when we went on BGT, stuff like musical theatre wasn't hugely in the forefront. So to think that we've been able to inspire, you know, events like this cruise and meet all of you guys, and we love hearing all your stories about how you've gotten into singing or even going to watch more musical theatre. So that makes everything worth it.
Thank you, Mike. Isn't Tommy?
Yeah, you guys have said all the good stuff now, haven't you? No, as these guys said, it's nice just to be able to wake up and even just pinching yourself 5 years later and going, I'm actually singing for my job. This is my dream. You know, I came to London. I tried to get into the West End. It's always been my dream to sing for a living, and that's what we get to do every single day. So.
Good.
Amazing.
Strong answers. I'd give those a strong 8 out of 10. Well done. Now, no, they're very good. So, advice. Right, I'm sure there's people out there that want to be where you are and working in shows, working in the West End, etc. What advice would you give to aspiring performers, my dears?
I think with any... You're going to go to do a lot of auditions and stuff, and there's always going to be a lot of knockbacks because it's such a competitive industry. There's always going to be the auditions where you walk in and you might not even get to sing. They just say, that's it, thank you. And you haven't even got to do anything yet, so you've got to be prepared for the knockbacks that you'll get and don't let it affect you.
Yeah, as well as like other people putting you down or not giving you a chance, you do have to persevere. But equally, and this is kind of the same for a lot of industries, you can't compare yourself to other people. Say, oh, you know, I want to be the next Alfie Beau, but you know, I'm not as good as him yet. You have to compare yourself to how good you were yesterday and keep striving to get better as yourself, and then eventually you will get to that level.
I totally agree, 100%, yes.
I would say learn... I know what is happening with my throat. Learn your value and learn how to say no to people, because when people start out in this industry, a lot of people end up doing things that they wouldn't necessarily want to do because they feel like they need to have the work or there's going to be a gap in their CV. There's a huge thing among people who are auditioning where you go from, you know, you go out of drama school and suddenly you need to work all the time, and you're worried that if a casting director or a producer sees your CV and there's a gap in there, then they aren't going to hire you, which was the case for quite a long time, but isn't so much now. So people need to learn, I think, how to say no rather than ending up on a contract they just knew they were never going to enjoy, or ending up in a job where they know they're not going to make any money because it's a bad profit share or something like that. Yeah. Learn how to say no.
Learn how to say no. You're very good at that, because usually when I walk towards you, you go, no! Which is why I had to sit over here and Jamie's over there. You see.
Don't take it personally. He does it to all of us.
I won't. No, I can understand. Now, have you, interestingly, talking about not comparing yourself, etc., social media can be a hard thing, can't it? And I think it's a wonderful tool in communicating and being able to be in contact with your lovely fans, your collaborators, and reaching out and putting your thoughts, your honest opinions out there, away from the press, as it were. But it also can be quite toxic, I think. So have you had any bad times on social media, trollings, etc., and how have you dealt with that, if you have?
Yes, and you just tell them to sod off.
Good. Good answer. Good answer.
No, everybody will always have an opinion, and obviously the internet's kind of the safest place to put that. Maybe not the safest, but the place with the least consequences for you.
Yes.
I think people just need to learn to not judge, especially if it's something that they could never do themselves.
Well, I agree. A lot of the time it's just jealousy, isn't it, really? And there's, I suppose people are hidden on the internet, aren't they, behind their keyboard or their phone, so it's very easy to... through the insults. But you're right, tell them to sod off or block them. Yes. Were you going to say something, Jamie, then? Michael, have you got a comment?
I don't think you should.
No, Jamie? No. No, good. Anything?
No, it's hard, isn't it? Because social media, like you say, is a place where you can be so close to your fans without necessarily being directly in front of them. And obviously we use social media to reach out to people, telling them what we've got coming up. I think sometimes, like you say, when people aren't necessarily a fan of something and they just want to cause a negative energy, it doesn't make sense to me personally. The only negative I've personally had is people can't decide whether I should be clean shaven or not. So the way around that is I just sometimes shave and then sometimes grow it.
You should do half. Yes, precisely, do half.
Yeah. I could do the same with my hair, but it might take a little longer.
Yeah. What do we think Tom should cut his hair?
No!
Good answer.
And what do we think about shaving? Yes or no? Do we do it bald, hands in hair? Hands in air, right. With facial hair, hands in air. Right, well, that was unanimous and a bloody waste of time, but I mean,
some of us don't have a choice.
But, yeah. I've got a bloody full-on beard underneath this, my dear. Right, we're going to do a quick fire round now before we do the Q&A with you, my dears. Okay, so we're going to go one at a time. I'm going to start with you, Thomas. All right, quick question. Say the first thing that comes in your mind. Okay, fruit or veg?
Oh, fruit.
Yeah, Michael or Elaine?
Elaine.
Hot or cold?
Hot.
Bed or day?
Day.
Swimming or sauna?
Oh, swimming.
Running or walking?
Running.
Neighbours or home and away?
Neighbours.
EastEnders or Coronation Street?
EastEnders.
Black or white?
Black.
Cameron Mackintosh or Andrew Lloyd Webber?
Cameron Mackintosh.
Simon Cowell or Amanda Holden?
Amanda Holden.
Okay, good. Alfie Bo or Michael Ball?
Oh.
Oh dear.
Alfie Bo, he's on the ship.
Yes, what an awesome idea, yes. At sea or at land?
Ooh, on sea, obviously.
Dom Perignon or Verve Creek?
Dom Perignon.
Premier Inn or Travel Lodge?
Premier Inn.
I mean, let's be honest, these boys haven't been in a Premier Inn in bloody years, have they? Is it not true?
No.
Okay. Soho House or the Grouchos?
Groucho.
Up north or down south?
Down south.
Oh! Same question to you. Up north or down south?
Definitely south for me.
Same question to you.
Up north.
Yes! Same question to you.
Both.
Shall we give him that? Yeah. All right, we're like, now that, my dears, because I can't think of any more fucking questions, is the end. Oh, Jesus, I keep swearing. I'm sorry. Don't be shy, my dears. Don't be shy. Let's ask the boys lots of wonderful questions while we've got this opportunity. So, hands in the air for this lovely lady over there. Hello, my dear.
Will you be coming to America soon?
We...
On tour.
That's a good question. Watch this space.
Oh. That's a horrible answer to have to give, yeah. But make sure you're available between March and June.
2025.
Yeah, potentially.
2025. Right, who's next? Any more? Oh yes, I'm over there, look. Yes, there.
What's the price on Jamie's shoes?
These shoes?
You got a price on me?
About?
£2.35.
Yeah. It's not actually there. I did rip most of it off. But have I got anything on this foot?
Yeah.
No. What did they say? Is it really bad? I didn't buy these. I got given these.
You've tore that one off as well, but I think they were £2.
I got given these by BGT champions, actually. So, there you go.
Well, there we are. Right, next.
Oh, yes, there we go.
Yeah. Hello, I love your song Lighthouse. Are you going to do an album of all your own songs at any time?
I think that would require us having to sit down and write all our own songs, which I don't know. I know that Tom particularly would love to do an album.
I think it would be amazing.
But no one would buy it.
I think they would, my dear. I think they would. Right, who have we got next? Shall we go this side? Lady over there. There we are. Hello there.
Is there anybody who has helped you with your act to be where you are today?
Yeah. There's hundreds of people that we've met along the last sort of 5 years who've helped, haven't they? All the teams.
I think one of the main things is we've worked with a series of amazing musical directors.
One being Ed Rugman, who's with us on the ship. He's done the last couple of albums for us and the tours. And he's a genius. I mean, that's so the sound you hear on the stage is put together by an incredible team that works with us. So it's yeah, there's a lot of people that have helped us along the way. But for me, the boys.
Aww. That was very nice.
But I'll never say anything like that again. So
I was going to say, I hope someone filmed that moment.
Yes, lady over there. Yes, hello, my dear.
Hi. Do you plan to release a Christmas album?
Oh. No, we've been talking about this for a long time.
No. Michael's been talking about this for a long time.
I've said, boys, no matter what happens, if Collabro has to end for any reason, we're doing a Christmas album before it finishes. So,
so it will happen, but probably in 20 years.
Yes, lady on the front row. Oh, no, lady that side first, yes.
Morning, guys.
Hi, Heather.
I've got some chocolate brownies here for you, by the way, so don't would you ever consider redoing some of the songs that you've previously done? For example, I'm thinking Stars, Bring Him Home, that you did in the early days. Would you ever consider doing them and putting them on future albums?
Yeah, we've talked about that. You know, as time goes on, the sound's kind of changed a bit for a couple of reasons. And but yeah, I think we would like to revisit those songs and do it as we do it now, because the harmonies have changed in some of the songs as well. So yeah, definitely.
Do you do carrot cake as well? But I love a moist carrot cake, please. Right? Room 9666, please, by 6 p.m. this evening, my dear. Yes, thank you. I will pay you in kindness. Right, who's next? Yes, my dear.
Hey, you guys. You produced your last two albums, and obviously this one is now under...
BMG, yes.
Has it been an easier ride for you, would you say? Has it been a...
Yes, I think obviously because we learned to work together so well on the third album, which was Home, and then Most of the World Ever Whole. It was a really nice process, and we had complete creative control. So, for example, had we done the fifth album ourselves, we probably would have stuck with musical theatre. I think we were thinking about stuff like Dear Evan Hansen and like musicals that have come out recently, which doesn't mean to say that we won't ever do that again. But BMG had quite a clear cut idea of what they wanted to do with us. And that was in many ways quite refreshing because we were knackered after both of the albums that we did ourselves. And then the 52-day tour this year, we came off that tour, and when BMG came in and said, look, we want to do an album with you, we've got an idea about how we want to do it, and we're going to pay for it. then obviously we were like, great, let's do it.
Good, yes. Over here, yes, at the top there, yes. We'll get to you at the front, madam.
Hello. I've got three little questions. One, are we allowed some brownie? Two. Number two.
No, you're not. It's all mine.
I need to be on a diet. Number two, work-life balance. I've got a little girl, I think I mentioned to you, that is really interested in singing, but I'm always keen to put her off because I think, as a girl, may go on to have a married life and children. Being out every single night or on weekends, is that very difficult? Or does the love of singing overcome that? Third question, will you do a tiny bit of Shallow for us? A tiny bit.
Third question, no.
We'll have to come on Thursday and see.
Yeah, maybe. So the second question, I think, kind of goes back to what Jamie was saying about knowing when to say no. I mean, you've got to have that balance, and it's kind of... If you don't want to be out on weekends, you don't have to be out on weekends. You've just got to learn how to say no, and then that's kind of that. So, no, it's getting the balance right is important, but just say bloody no.
Plus, family-wise, Jamie's the only one with a daughter, so...
It's a pug. Matt's absolutely right. And there are lots of really successful examples of women in the industry who have kids and still manage to maintain a family life and be very successful. So it's about, I think, holding those people up as examples.
We were on tour, obviously, last time with Kerry Ellis, and obviously she's a very large family woman. And you know what I mean?
Good God.
A large woman.
Can't wait to get that text.
That's like the headline, large family. But no, she had her kids, like, we saw them a couple of times, they were running around the stage, having a lovely time. They were actually really nice.
Yeah.
She has a really good balance of kind of work.
She never stops working, either.
Yeah.
Because let's swiftly move on from large careerists. Who's next? Oh, yes, over here. We're going to get to you, madam, I promise you. We just need to get the mic to you. Okay, I'll come to you in a minute, my dear.
Hi, guys.
Hello.
Have you ever thought of bringing out a DVD of you doing all your favourite hits?
Yeah.
Yes. Every tour, but the problem is it's incredibly expensive to, for example, we want to do the Royal Albert Hall.
Oh.
But it's tens and tens and tens of thousands of pounds to even just get the rights to use the name to put on a DVD. So we would love to do it, but we'd have to work out a sort of... we've got mortgages, yeah. No, we would love to do it. I think it would be even just a nice record for us to have, wouldn't it? So it is something we're really keen on doing, definitely. We were thinking about it and we'll work it out.
Right, I believe there's one at the back there. Hello, sir. Madam, sorry, you're a long way away. Good God.
Hello. Just to say, you're brilliant and you were absolutely robbed on Britain's Got Talent.
Yeah. We love you.
And secondly, please, are you coming next year?
On the cruise?
Yes.
Well, can't say for definite, but we are on tour in October in the UK, so maybe not. Don't know. Probably
not. I'm sure you can fit us in for two nights.
We'll see.
We'll have a chat with our management.
Got to be collaborative.
Maybe the cruise will stop on one of our tour dates. And you can all get off.
Guess what, guys? Next year, you're all going to Liverpool.
We'll just helicopter you in, my dears, for a couple
Deal.
Of hours, then helicopter you out again. I mean, why don't we do that? Now, I have somebody... Oh, right. Yes, here, and then this lady on the front row. Yes.
Hi, I'm Pauline. I just wondered, when you sort of knew that money was no object, what individual thing did you buy that you thought, I must have that?
We'll let you know when it happens.
Yes. Yeah.
No, I went and bought majority of the Apple store.
What's nice is that we've all got like mortgages and houses now, which is not something that many people of our age in this industry can do. So that's definitely something that has been a positive thing for us.
You know, I've never bought anything big, but there's a Japanese restaurant by my house, and they know me.
You bought it?
No. I was going to say, they know me by name. Like, I'm in there so often.
I've never bought anything big, but I did buy a restaurant.
It's strange. None of us are really splurges, are we? Like,
I beg your pardon.
What? Sorry.
None of us go...
You can see in his eyes when he's saying something like that he knows it's happening and can't stop himself.
Oh, yeah, so the only exciting... Matt did stay in the Shard a couple of nights a week for a while. Yeah.
No, I did stay in the Shard for £700 a night.
I'm like Elton John. And then he said, when are we getting paid? But
right.
No, I think we're all just so grateful that before Britain's Got Talent, we were all, you know, struggling to pay our rent and just working day jobs just to literally make ends meet. And now if we... want to go to a restaurant for dinner rather than cooking ourselves, we can, but I don't think any of us feel like we could just...
I wouldn't like to cook myself.
Oh, my God.
Jamie's a comedian in his spare time. like we say, we've all now gotten on the property ladder, which is great, and we're just... No one's bought a Ferrari just yet.
They've just bought this ship, though, just to let you know. They bought it last night. It's been renamed the Collaborator. Collaborator of the Seas.
The Collaborator of the Seas is a great name.
Isn't it? Yes, I agree, my dear. I think it's wonderful. Now, we're coming to you, my dear. I see my friend going like that at the back. Who's at the back? Hello? Oh, yes, it's a lovely lady. Hello,
hello
my
hello,
dear.
Hi, boys. We saw you last year. Amazing. Oh. Can't wait to see you later. Now, you all get on very, very well, but there must be some niggles between you. Who has the worst habit?
Oh, of course there is. I think...
Worst habit.
Michael's got this horrible... I'm joking. No, I mean...
Oh, I'm a tapper.
Oh, yeah. So I think I tell Tom off about 30 times a day for just sitting tapping like that. And I'm like, Tom! I mean, we all, yeah, we argue from time to time, but we kind of have the argument and then we move on and have a laugh.
As all brothers do.
Yeah. That's, yeah.
Oh, I was going to say something. No.
Go on.
I love them all.
It's, you can't. Oh, go on.
He's going to say something awful. It's probably about me, so come on.
No, it's only, I was just going to say, Tom's got a habit of...
Oh, stop picking on Tom.
Of not replying to any messages and then going, hey, boys, what's going on tomorrow?
Oh, no, I've got another one, actually. I said, Tom. He's the nicest person in the world.
This is going to be the reason we break up.
Probably. So, with any band, there's decisions that have got to be made, right? So, let's say, Jamie has an opinion. I have the same opinion as Jamie. Michael has a different opinion. Tom, it's down to you. He says, oh, I don't mind.
And I genuinely don't.
And Michael's like, fight my corner.
Like, come on, Tom, we need to make it 2-2.
Yeah, but, we, yeah.
So it's you, basically, Tom.
Yeah. Random chant.
Can we all have an R for Tom, please? It's all right, I'll give you my counsellor's number after this session. Now, I've got a lady at the front row who needs a question. Hello, my dear. Sorry it's taken so long, but this is your moment. Go for it, my dear.
Well, I'm not asking for myself. I'm asking for a very dear collaborator, Sabine from France.
Oh, that's Sabine.
She hesitated to ask you this question, so I'm asking for her. She wants to know how you all decide when you're doing a gig or an album or something, how you all choose, how do you go about choosing the songs that are going to be performed or done on the album and so forth?
So album-wise, we maybe sit down over dinner and we just suggest songs and we write them down and maybe we have a list of 100 different songs. And then we kind of peter them out from there. Peter them out? Oh, that works. Some of them we go, those two songs are very similar, but this one's better. Or we go, I really like that song and not that one so much. So we get the list down to about 20, 30, and then we kind of try them all out physically. We try to sing them, and some of them just work better when we workshop them than others. And it just keeps kind of going down like that and down like that until we have 10 songs that we really, really like and we think are the best ones for that album.
Or BMG can come in and tell you what you're singing.
Yeah. Oh.
Two options. Now, even then, no, they said, we've got suggestions for you, we'd love your suggestions, and it was kind of an amalgamation of the two, wasn't
yeah,
it?
Yeah, very much.
Sure. Yes, my dear, over there we are. Hello.
Hi, guys. It's wonderful to see you on the cruise. As you know, we've got two theme nights this week, so what are you coming dressed as tonight?
What is tonight?
Character.
Musical theatre characters.
Oh, well, that's Collabro.
Yeah.
Well, that's a good idea, isn't it? Collabro the musical. There. So here's a question for you. What musical theatre stars would play you in Collabro the musical?
If somebody produced Collabro the musical and didn't cast us...
You can't play yourself.
I think I'd be a bit offended.
You'd be on, no, but you'd be on tour, my dear.
No one could possibly play me but me.
I'd be like, I'm perfect for this role.
But my dear, you'd be on Equity Minimum. There's no point. Yes, far better being on tour. Who would you like? Come on, who do you think?
Russell Crowe for Jamie.
Absolutely.
Russell Crowe.
Vito.
It had to be younger people, right?
Yes, it's about to be younger people, yes.
Who's young? Jack Yarrow?
Jack Yarrow to play you.
Jack Sparrow?
Jack Yarrow, who's currently playing
Joseph.
Oh, just finished.
Yes, it's finished.
Just
now.
Finished playing Joseph.
Is that for you?
I don't know. Tom, maybe?
I have no idea. Yeah, sure. I'll take him.
Who else is?
Yeah. You have to choose a different one now.
I'd want Ben Platt to play me so I could have a better voice.
Aww.
Jamie's like, yes, but he doesn't want to say it out loud.
No, I'm just trying to I don't know who would play me. I don't know. Elaine Page.
Elaine Page, go on.
Mel Street.
Have you any idea?
Oh, I don't know. Luke Baer.
Oh, yeah.
That's a good shout. That's a very good shout.
Luke Baer. Oh, yes, that's a good one.
Lovely
yes.
Luke.
Yeah. Okay, good. Well done. We've done that one. All right, who's next? Where are we going? There? Oh, we're going here. Well done. Yes, hello, my dear.
Hello.
Hello.
I love to collect vinyls.
Have you ever considered putting any of your music out on vinyls?
It would be a nice thing to do. It's a business proposition, there's not a lot in it nowadays, so it's probably more of a commemorative.
I've got a vinyl player.
Let's do it then.
It'd probably good to do like a limited number of them.
Yeah, we could do it for like the next record. We could do like a...
Yeah, just a little special thing.
The new commemorative edition. That
we don't think a lot of people would buy them, but we think like for some people that would, it might be just
a nice thing to do.
Yeah.
That could be the Christmas record. Yeah. That's really sweet, actually. We'll make 100 and then just...
It was like when people were asking what merchandise people wanted, and people said they wanted bed sheets with our pictures on.
The response was immediately, absolutely not.
It's weird. Going back to the Christmas album quickly, I think the problem with the Christmas album, we'd love to do one, and I think we probably eventually will, but the problem is, people will play it, and they'll get back to the end of the album and go, oh, that was lovely. Pop Michael Bublé in.
Yeah.
Is that Michael Bublé.
Good, let's move on.
Is that your question? That was a good one. What's your name, my dear?
Patty.
I'm from Canada. Patty LuPone's in, my dear. Yes, Patty. Well, if you do that vinyl,
Patty gets
you can
one.
We'll mention you. They can mention you because you've inspired them.
Good idea.
Right, merchandise. When are the Collabro blow-up dolls coming out? Yes, well, you see, they want them, my dear. Life-size Collabro blow-up dolls.
Right here.
We're up for that, yes, yes. Well, right, yeah. Get your orders in. Right, okay, we've got a question here.
I have a question for Tom. Can I give you...
Is that cheese? What is it?
It's a stone, and I draw a Bulbasaur on it.
Yeah,
come on,
that's
come
nice.
Come and give it.
Are you brother and sister?
Thank you so much.
Cool, so where's ours?
Very flexible, aren't
you? It's a Bulbasaur. It's really good.
That's
Thank
gorgeous.
You. That's insane.
That's lovely.
Yeah, it's my, for those of you who don't know, I have quite a few Pokemon tattoos, and that's literally... This
That's
one right
so
here.
Nice.
So, thank you very much. Thank you so much. That's amazing.
Oh, well done, my dears. Well done. Yes, yes, my dear lady behind.
Hello.
Hi.
Hello.
Obviously, like, you just said that you came from just working normal jobs. Has it ever, like, freaked you out about being in the limelight and having loads of fans and girls screaming wherever you go? Is it overwhelming?
I mean, that doesn't happen, but...
I've seen it.
That's only like when we walk out of our cabins first thing in the morning, everyone's like, ooh.
That's because you're not wearing any clothes. No, I think obviously the support that we've had has been amazing, and obviously once we came off the show, we were at a level, and it was amazing, and obviously you guys have kept us there, so it's down to you guys that we absolutely love our job. So we've never panicked much.
Well, I'm afraid we're nearly out of time. Okay, we're going to ask you, my dear. Go on, you look desperate. Go on.
Hello.
Hello.
I think I'm the only male that's asked a question. Could I put a request in for an album of powerful hymns, Jerusalem, Abide by Me?
That's a lovely idea, actually.
How great thou art.
We did Jerusalem, didn't we?
We did. With Catherine Jenkins.
Oh.
And we also did Abide With Me at Soccer Aid.
That's right.
Yeah, so we do have a repertoire in order to do it. Mm-hmm. So my
hymns are designed to have that kind of power, aren't they? Yeah. And that sort of, it would be lovely with a massive orchestra. And yeah, it would be a lovely idea. And I think people would buy them as well, which would be nice.
Also, I think... we could do like a Collabro like lullaby album for children as well. I think that's one that people are asking.
Listen, there's enough people go to sleep to our concert as it is, so
we actually did a version of Amazing Grace, but we did it at an event where someone else was headlining. I won't name names, but they said that our version was too good for the headline act to have to follow it, so we weren't allowed to do it.
Can't tell you. Sorry. They're on this ship. They're not.
Well, my dears, I think sadly we have to bring this to an end. So what have we learnt, my dears? We've learnt that Collabro needs to do a Christmas album, that they need to do a vinyl, we need to do a hymn album, thank you, sir. And we need their fans, their collaborators, to make us all some carrot cake, and also that people are desperate for the Collabro blow-up dolls. That is what we have learnt today on this wonderful Q&A session, my dears. And before we go, we are all going to collaborate together, finally, for one final time. And in the words of Michael, we are all going to go balls. One, two, three, balls! Stop! Well done, my dears! Round of applause for Collabro! Bravo, my dears. Thank you.
See you on Thursday.
Jamie. Carla. Oh, yeah.